You can print the flower on the bed of your printer just like this, but then you will have support material that will go from each of these petals all the way down to the bed. And when you remove that, I use rotary files, different grinding stones to smooth this out after I remove it. And then this red has a bit of a pink or whitish cast to it where it's been ground and it doesn't look very nice. I have a video on chemically welding these PLA and PETG parts together. And I took a dental applicator and just put some of that solvent on here and it makes it shiny again, but it's still rough and it doesn't look very good. I didn't like the looks of it. Even the base down here had a bunch of support material that had to be removed. So the following shows you how to split the flower in half and how to mirror it so you can get a left and a right hand piece that will look much better with the hummingbird. I'm going to import the flower into Cura, set it on the base, and the slot in the bottom is a bit off center, so we want to split that through that rectangular slot. Turn it exactly 90 degrees and rotate the bed up. Now we're going to turn it another 90 degrees. Exactly 90 degrees. We want to lower the flower along the z-axis half of its height. So at 66.2, we're going to lower it a minus 33.1. Now only that portion which is above the bed will print. The other half will not print. And you can see where it's needing support. It's highlighted in red. Go ahead and slice it. We go to layered view. We click on the helper, or what is the support material. It shows up as supporting the inside of the flower. And we rotate one side. We can see we got a little bit of support on another petal. The opposite side, a little bit there. And in the back, we've got a little support that's holding that rectangular rounded opening. Now we can remove the flower, and that's the support material which will need to be removed when we're done. And now we're going to mirror the flower. Click on the mirror function, select a direction to mirror. That's all it takes. I'm going to slice that. And we can remove the flower. That's the support material, which will be removed. Put the flower back. We're done. I printed the left and right hand pieces, and I've marked these because I'm making more than one flower, just to keep from getting the pieces mixed up, and all that support material has to come out of there. And when it's out of there, it will look like this. And I use the rotary files and the grindstones to smooth that out. And when this goes together, you're not really going to be able to see much that has been ground on. But I will take some of that solvent and I will put it on here that will make that shiny again. O-ring or rubber band around that to kind of help hold that together a little bit. I'm just going to tack a few spots here, let it set up, then turn it over, get everything lined up. I'm gonna try and glue everything together from the inside. Then hopefully I won't have a shiny spot on the seam out here. I'll put some glue along the seam on the inside, and then I put it on the back side of the pedal through here. The solvent is thin and wicks into the joint.